crash marks. This shrine is defiled by their presence. See that the orb they stole is returned to the mausoleum beneath the cathedral. This mausoleum is a memorial to Etekilum, Malori, the first wayfinder to traverse this ley line. Like a star burning in the blackness of space, a beacon for others, aspirational. But it was her insatiable curiosity that took her life when she ventured into the Black Garden against my wishes, and never returned. Take a moment to reorient yourself, Guardian. This cache is placed on a... cache contains planar telemetry about an attempted breach of the Ascendant plane from somewhere else. Infestations spreading like a cancer through the ley lines. These need to be cleared. Served as springs of ascendant energy, used by Artekians to sculpt structures such as this. Now they are barren parodies of their once noble purpose. One day, perhaps, they will shine again. This cache holds record of the Harbingers, ancient weapons we set to bear against the Hive God, Oryx. When we attacked Oryx's dreadnought, three Tekians and I set the Harbingers upon him. It took all our powers to call forth weapons of such impossible destruction, all for naught. Now his sister awaits me, lingering in her crystal coffin. A move against her will not succeed if guided by force alone. Harvesting ascendant energy with such simple, brute force. They must be stopped. Thank you. appears these decaying vermin have discovered a means to refine ascendant energy. Corsair wayfinding cache. Information on their search for me through the ruins of this place. The dark intellect in the Scorn is a cruel reflection of their former lives as Elixni. But to have reverse-engineered a process to refine ascendant energy, they could not have done this on their own. Stage some sort of ritual combat. This is not of Elixni culture. Are they developing their own? Remove these vermin. This data cache was left by one of my Techians after the Battle of Saturn. It bears my name. She was trying to reach me through the power of her will. She entered this plane and summoned me. And she succeeded, after a fashion. Rest. Your queen has heard your call. Appeared to be in the early stages of developing some form of trial by combat. I'm reminded of your crucible, Guardian. Mockeries of life, sloughing off the skin of their former culture. If the Scorn are learning, changing, what are they becoming? This place, even if it's changed. The data cache here has old combat logs of mine. At the beginning of the Dreaming City's curse loop, we held out until the end, but we were down to our blades against the Taken. We heard voices, A sea of awoken reinforcements surged at our backs. They came from a split in the plains. I thought we were saved. And then I recognized some of their faces. My corsairs. Friends who had already fallen in the battle. The curse loop was starting over. I led the same friends to their deaths again. And again. Let's keep moving. Now opens its gates to you. When the Hive first invaded this realm, we imprisoned their undying emissary beneath this tower. Now you will do what we could not. We can't stop her. She can flood the plains with endless troops, and there's nothing we can do but hold out as long as we can. Termites in rotting wood, spreading out from the borders of their progenitors' throne worlds. To end the Hive, you must end them at their source, for without the worm gods, they are as fragile as glass. see that it is undone, Guardian. Other wizards, somewhere beyond the portals, maintaining this ritual. They must be stopped. Is corrupted. The Hive tried to gain access by force. We spent ages keeping these lines clear. Then Zero Arath gets involved and suddenly we have waves of Hive breaking down our doors. The Corsairs and Techians had it under control. Even while facing an endless curse from a wish dragon, it never got this bad. Realm and Zevor Arath's throne world? I am uncertain such a ritual could have succeeded. Zevor Arath must be desperate to stop Savathun. How unfortunate for her.